Good morning, everyone. I am Priyanka Karunakaran. I am a model. I am a professional model from Mumbai. I am a model who you may or may not have seen in TV commercials and print campaigns. Well, I'm also that model who was rejected to contest for Miss India. I'm the model who did not get that big Hollywood break or the three-film deal contract, the big beauty launch pad or the ad campaign that could change my life. Yes, I am that model, like every other model who faces rejection on a daily basis. But along my journey of trial and error, I've had some very fortunate moments, and I would like to share a few highlights with you. These are a few covers that I was very fortunate to be a part of: Travel and Leisure, Maxim, editorials for Bazaar, some German magazines, GQ Italia. This is some of my work. This is the Kingfisher calendar 2018, lensed by Atul Kasbeka. More editorials. TV commercials with Priyanka Chopra for Silver Pearls, Bima Jewelers, Jabong, Maruti Suzuki, Visa Card, with All Engine Oil. Some work from London, print campaigns, and more. What I realized is what I saw as rejection was actually redirection. Let me take you back to a time when none of this had happened to me. I was enthusiastic, I was energetic, I was ambitious, I knew my goals, and I wanted to achieve all of them. With all this energy and all this enthusiasm, I attended every audition and every casting call. Yes, I did crack a few jobs here and there, but not the opportunities that I wanted to. I just felt that they were not a big enough platform for my potential. I was told that I'm too short to be a model. Models stand 5'7 and above, I'm somewhere between 5'5, 5'6. I'm too short to be a model. I was also told that dark girls are not meant for TV commercial modeling. I was told that fair girls look much more upmarket, fair girls can sell lifestyle products, and dark girls cannot. These excuses and these reasons became a permanent voice in my head. Every single time I would go for an audition, these voices would play in my head over and over again, and obviously they would show in my performance. As a result, I just stopped bagging jobs. It was a downward spiral, and I was rejected over and over again. I was dejected, and I could see my dreams crumble right in front of my eyes. I hoped and looked for someone who would support me, who would give me that big break, who would launch me, or give me a movie, or put me on a magazine cover, something. I was looking for someone to believe in me. But no one came to my rescue. I was depressed, I was jobless, I was penniless, and I was in a bad condition. And trust me, I didn't want to be there. I would do just about anything to get out of that condition. Lucky for me, I like to read. So I started reading. I didn't read fictional stories that transport you to a different world and escape from your reality. I read about real people. I read about real heroes, people who pursued their dreams and achieved them. I read about Oprah Winfrey. I read how she did not let the history of her past affect her dreams and her future. I read about Sourav Ganguly and his fierce, aggressive spirit on the field. I read about Steve Jobs and his discipline and his minimalistic lifestyle. I read about Serena Williams, who dominated her industry for 20 years. They say the lifespan of a sports person is somewhere between 4 to 5 years, but she broke that rule. And she played when she was pregnant, she played after she delivered her baby. How inspiring is that? I read about Meryl Streep, who reinvented herself with every single movie. I read about them. I read about their values. I read about their principles and their qualities, and I wondered, what would it be like to be like that, to get up every single time you fall down, to keep fighting no matter what? And so I started acting and pretending that these qualities are actually my qualities. These qualities of my hero, of never giving up, of being persistent, patient, disciplined, and performing are my qualities. So I made this armor, this strong, beautiful armor with all these qualities. And every single time I walked out the door for an audition, I would wear this armor. And trust me, every time I did not give in to a distraction or starved my fear, my armor just became stronger, like the Avenger series. You know, with each movie, Iron Man's suit just kept getting better. Every time I starved a fear of mine, my armor kept getting stronger. And that's when I realized, the minute you get rid of unwanted baggage and accept your shortcomings, acknowledge yourself for who you are, your strengths and your weakness, you give yourself a power. So what if I'm not tall? I'm a fashion degree holder. I understand fashion illustration. That helps me to pose in front of the camera. I understand garments and textile and the movement of textile. I understand framing and light work because of being a design student. I was a dancer. My mom enrolled me in Bharatnatyam and Kuchipudi when I was 3 years old, which meant that I knew how to move in front of the camera. These were my strengths. These made me feel empowered. I became my own hero, like you are your own hero. And now it was time for my hero to tackle my next demon. In a country that is obsessed with fair skin, and in an industry where fair skin is called upmarket, and only fair skin girls can sell lifestyle products, how do I make my mark? How do I change this mentality? How do I change the mentality of a billion people? I cannot. I cannot change the mentality of a billion people. And I will not change my skin color. But what I can do is that I can change my approach towards these jobs. So what I started doing is that I just completely rid myself of the pressure of the final result. I decided to give my 100% to the job on hand without bothering of what's going to happen next. And yes, self-discipline, patience, persistence, performance, and all these qualities really matter. But the secret ingredient to giving your mind, body, and heart to the job on hand is to simply have fun. You know, my friends tell me that I have this Punjabi uncle inside of me. Every time I do something that's fun and I've enjoyed, I have this weird thing. I put my hand up like this and I'm like, wah, maza aa gaya, yaar, maza aa gaya. So, like, for instance, when my mom makes fish curry rice at home, like, I'm not big on carbs, but when there's fish curry rice, this Malayali girl will swipe clean her plate. I eat all of it. And when my belly is like a wee bit out and my lips curve into a smile, that's that feeling. Wah, maza aa gaya. Like some people will say, damn, that's sick, man. And the Italians would be like, mwah, bellissimo. I wanted that feeling. I wanted that feeling every single time I walked out the audition room. So I decided to have like these little experiments for myself. I would make it interesting. I love getting dressed, which is pretty apparent, I guess. So I started dressing up for my auditions according to the script. I would curl my hair, straighten it sometimes, play cute, play hot, play sexy, just be fun and make it fun for myself. I would watch online videos of actresses and try to emulate them in my auditions. And every single time I would accomplish a self-experiment, I would feel like a success. I guess that really showed in my auditions, because after that I endorsed quite a few brands, from cars to makeup to shampoo to sanitary napkins, all of them. I guess I just became fit to be a TV commercial model. And at this time, I would also like to say that we have to give credit to ad agencies, production houses, casting directors, and directors who showed courage to break the norm. I think advertising has a huge impact on society, and it really helps in changing the perspective of society, and all these people made brave choices. Which brings me to a point that when an Indian girl tells her family that she wants to join the fashion industry or the film industry, her family gets really, really skeptical. They're like, oh, it's a big bad world out there. There are monsters. Yes, it is a big bad world. But you guys have to know, the Indian fashion industry and the advertising industry has some extremely creative and talented people who come to work to do some serious business. I've been very fortunate to work with these creative and talented people, but besides that, I also have to say that they are exceptional human beings. Which brings me to my final point. Before being an entertainer, entrepreneurs, students, and teachers, we're human beings. And in this day of social media and swipe right and swipe left and delete and all of those things, we have to remember that the strongest mode of communication is human connection. Connect with the people you are around. You know, have meaningful conversations. Talk to people. But moreover, listen to them when they're talking. It's amazing what you can learn from someone else's experience. Connect to the moment you're in. Be present as a peacock in the moment. Know what is happening around you. You know, attention is the purest and rarest form of generosity. Give attention generously to the people around and to the moment you are in. Don't be afraid to feel too much. Don't be afraid to care too much and show that you care. Don't be afraid to be extra. When you are that little extra in your daily being, you become extraordinary. When you leave that room, you leave behind your energy. You leave behind your sparkle. You leave behind your magic. You know, I've had a lot of fun on this whole journey of coming here and talking to all of y'all. And I believe that I manifested this moment in my life. And yes, I picked up a lot from our first speaker. And I'm sure you guys have also picked up something. So if you've picked up one line that is going to stay with you, or one experience that may change your life, or one sentence that you're going to remember when life is beating you down, I hope when you walk out this audi today, you raise your hand up and say, wah, maza aa gaya. Thank you very much.